could do this every day. We kind of do.
She's going to a single mom's group just to hang out and just on every week?
Yeah, every week on Mondays.
She just got she's transitioned to a new job. So like, it's just like everything is like, the Lord's hand is just like, I love you, Veronica, I want to help you. That's what he's saying to you. Okay, so on the yellow, okay, if you put your thumb on number one, on here, and open it up. Yep, and then you can open it up. And then you're going to see a verse that's highlighted. Can you read it out loud?
For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Okay, so in your past, have you ever experienced anybody that sins?
Of course.
Everybody sitting at the table.
For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Okay, so your new job, you're going to get paid, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it's a wage. It's what you earn. So if everybody sins, according to that verse, what happens? We all earn what?
Death?
Yeah, death. Yeah. Right? I mean, it kind of sucks. It's simple, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
You know, this is what's really cool is he's from Dallas. He's from Sarasota. I'm from here. We're from all different places, but yet we all know this is true.
All right, let's go to number three. So you only get five words. So you're doing great, by the way.
But God demonstrates his own love towards us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Your 10-year-old son. How do you demonstrate love to him?
I ask him how he's feeling, because I want him to know that he has someone that will always be there and he can talk to.
The way God tangibly shows us his love, he sent his son Jesus to be right with us. Just like you are with your son, God did that with Jesus. And it says he died for us even while we're still a mess.
So sometimes it's so reassuring to know that no matter what is happening on this plane, I have a father who loves me no matter what.
I think this one here for you is your answer to everything.
For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that is not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not as a result of works, so that no one may boast.
What do you think that means?
That he saves you through your faith. But it's your faith in him.
So there's nothing that Veronica or Kyle or Lorian, none of us can do anything to get a relationship with him except have faith in what he did for us on the cross. To me, this is where you're at today. This is what I'm sorry, not number six, but number five, the green. This is what I want to see take place in your life today. This is where you're at. So.
That if you confess with your mouth Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart a person believes, resulting in righteousness, and with the mouth he confesses, resulting in salvation. I want to say that I'm transitioning there.
Yeah.
I'm slowly trusting in him. Because yeah. I've always believed in God, but I didn't fully put myself out there. Which, being in the single moms group has helped.
Okay, so let's do it. You're ready. Like, you're totally ready.
It's just been a crazy day, and you walked in at a crazy, extremely crazy day of my life. And where I walked into Disney Springs with confusion, and then I have someone walking up to me that I feel like you walked up to me because you've seen that. Remember, I saw you guys walk in, and I saw the way that you walked in with a purpose. I know that when God is speaking to you, there's no way to avoid it, and there's just like that person today.
It's today.
Yeah.
All right, so let's do this. I feel like we should hold hands. Come on. Okay, I want you to tell the Lord, I mean, you say, Jesus, you're my Lord. Tell him right now in your prayer.
Jesus, you are my Lord. I know that you are in control of my life and everything going on in my life. And I know that you will take care of me and help me through this time as you always have before. Everything that will be okay, and I leave it in your hands.